Surf Rider Hotel will be up here on the right-hand side. This lovely property we're going to pass by, it's was the First Lady of Waikiki, first hotel resort built here in 1901.
Yeah.
Across the street from the one Surf Rider, this is the International Marketplace. It's changed a lot. It used to be a flea market, and now you can buy Teslas and Rolex watches and everything. Now, of course, a lot of folks wish it was still a flea market. Where's Target? I need a Target.
Walmart.
Walmart. Sam's Club. So this is the Moana Surf Rider here on the right, guys. Kings and queens have stayed here. This is a lovely property, the first in Waikiki. Built in 1901 by Walter Peacock. Guess how much your room was back in 1901? There's your hint. 1901. $1 in 1901. Duke statue coming up next. Duke Khan and Moku. The ambassador of Aloha. Three-time Olympic gold medal winner in swimming, freestyle swimming. First sheriff of Honolulu. Credited with bringing the ancient sport of surfing into the modern era.
Thank you, Malcolm.
You're welcome. Bye, ladies. Thank you, Mahalo. Blue line, folks. Standing room only, it looks like. We're going to be a little crap if you guys can squeeze over. We should appreciate it. This is the blue line. Welcome. Anybody getting off at Diamond Head to do the hike? No? Thank you. Blue line. Mahalo. Mahalo. Right there to the right, they make up. This is Queen Beach. one if any, to make up world famous Waikiki Beach. Kaimana is just up here, in the grassy area. All together. Take seven to make world famous Waikiki. This is Kapi'olani Park we're passing through right now. 300 acre park site here. I don't know, it kind of has a Central Park feel to it, a little bit. Part of this, though, 30 acres of it is for the zoo over here to our left. Can't really see it from here. We'll pass by on the way back in. Again, the trip takes about 2 hours, folks, start to finish. But if you get off at one of the stops, there'll be another trolley back in an hour to pick you up. I'm Little I'm One, the other trolley will be Line 2. There's a banyan tree, probably an example of a banyan tree right up there to the left, or to the right, I mean, my other left, my right. Hold on to your hats, guys, we get unexpected gusts all the time on these runs. So if you have a favorite hat, please hold on to it. For you guys understanding, maybe we're going to get it. I had a toupee on my first time. It's gone. All I have left is my toupee.
Oh, they have a war memorial
here? It's in a clip. It didn't blow away. Just my toupee. There's a fountain up here in this median. It's the Louis Dillingham Memorial Fountain. This was installed, well, actually, the first one was installed after World War I. And it was honoring Japanese immigrants to the islands. It was gifted to us by the Emperor of Japan, in fact. But as you can imagine, after the attack on Pearl Harbor and the start of World War II, for us anyway, it fell in disfavor. So they took the old fountain out and they replaced it with this one in about 64, mid-60s. And this is the Louise Dillingham Memorial Fountain. I don't know, it kind of has a very mature look to it, don't you think? A little bit. TV show. Come on. Nobody's both silent. Oh, I forgot. All right. Hey, I got to go quiet from here to the lighthouse. Okay, I'll explain it to you once we get up here, but I'm going quiet for a while. Yes, please. every time. What a location. Now, the reason I went quiet back there is that that's a pretty exclusive neighborhood back there, and they have asked us not to make extra noise, like on our PA when we go through there, so we are honoring that request. That's high dollar back there, folks. High dollar neighborhood. If it starts getting weird rain, everybody should put down the rain flaps. That will definitely help. So they just, in case I can't make it back there, we're so crowded. There's just little clamps, right, over attached to these little ovens. You seen all our chickens? We had free-range chickens before it was even a thing. They were let loose a long time ago, supposedly to control the bugs and stuff in the grass. So they let them go, and the chickens have maintained the bug population in the grass in and around the island. There's another story. I don't know if it's true, but a big storm went through back in the day when all the chickens were caged up and fenced up. It blew them all over, opened up the cages, freed the chickens, they got loose. And after the storm subsided, people just kind of looked around at all the loose chickens and were like, ah, forget about it. Diamond Head, again, there's a hike up to the top of Diamond Head crater on our left here, one of many dormant volcano craters here on Oahu and in the islands. About 750 feet up to the top, there's a hiking trail. It's paved, some of it's paved, not all of it. It's a little challenging at times. There's some uneven ground, some loose rock. It's $5, a big $5 donation to go to the top. Great views up there, of course. You can access it from our next stop, which is coincidentally Diamond Head. Now, when you get down with your hike, some of you chose to do that now, and you want to continue the tour, you would get on where I dropped you off, so you get back on the same place I dropped you off. If you just want to go back into Waikiki after that, you can go across the street and get on with that stop. That's as the trolley's come back into town.